G'day everyone, OzArt here. Today we are making an electronic puppet of indie comic book creator Liam Gray. You may remember Liam from my previous livestream where I turned a statue of him riding a turtle into a sprite for my game, Mr. Dong's Collector. I've captured a screenshot of Liam from one of his livestreams. After sifting through thousands of frames, I shortlisted a selection to work from. The great thing about Liam is that his face is almost a perfect oval. His features are also completely rounded in each aspect. We have to isolate the features that we will be moving. The lower jaw for speech, and I want the eyebrows to shift from angry to happy, as those are the two states that best represent Liam. The effect of clipping the lower mandible from one frame and positioning over another frame gives immediate comic potential. By leaving the mouth slightly smaller than the underlying mouth, it transformed Liam from real to puppet, affecting a wooden dummy, I think. It is now firmly in the protection environment of satire. We want our puppet to be activated by my game controller. Let's separate his base face on one layer and make the jaw as an object we can code. I've pasted the controller code I use for my games. It recognizes the gamepad and we can assign what button has what effect. It is set to move our jaw object with the directional stick and the cross-shaped D button. It also sets a dead zone which gives the joystick a bit of play. It's kinda crazy. It's leaving large screen artifacts and is really jerky in movement. Liam mouth is kind of hypnotizing. Liam mouth cobra. Liam spermatozoa. I've pasted in code for the jaw to move back to its origin if I move it away. We can adjust the speed to get the movement just right for speech. The normals flip left and right, up and down. We can stop that by keeping the image X and Y scales to equal to 1. We could probably remove the code altogether. You may remember my clamp code from part 2 of making a commie NPC video. We can apply it here to stop the jaw moving lower or higher than we want. Once I am happy with the mouth movement, we can create a new object that rotates the eyebrows, again borrowing from the traditional marionette. It's set to turn visible when I move down, and stay invisible when I move upward. The movement is okay after some play with the movement speeds, but it's pretty restrictive, so I programmed the movement of the eyebrows to the second joystick on my controller. Also, I need some eye movement to provide more expression. I'm cutting out a superhero mask shape for his eyes. I'm going to paint his eyelids in the same manner that Disney used to paint Minnie Mouse. I set up the closed eyes to use the same code as the eyebrows, and change it to being visible every time I press button 3 on my controller.
When life seems full of clouds and rain, and I am full of nothing and pain, who soothes my thumping, bumping brain?
One problem with the 2D world is that objects viewed front on don't allow for how we really see them. Our eyes are set apart, and so we actually are able to see more around the curvature of an object in real life, revealing their aspects hidden in a photo, such as earlobes. I need to compensate for this by artificially introducing ears onto the puppet. We can add the ears as a separate object, but I'm not animating them.
Let's play Mr. Dongus Collector. How many dongus can you find? I bet you can find all of the dongus. I have faith in you. There is a much adventure.
Help Mr. Dongs find priceless phallic objects of antiquity, starting with the jungles of Peru. Stage 1 is fully complete and ready for purchase. With over 23 levels of adventure. By the game end, it is yours forever.
Why are you not buying and playing it now?